say that, bend it, yeah, brake before the curve, lift off that brake, let your momentum carry you, your gas as you come out of the curve. So always brake before a curve, let your momentum carry you around the corner, your foot is over the brake in the beginning, foot slides to the gas, pedestrian activated lights again, no one's pushing buttons, we're good to go. Peekaboo the rear view. So the expression I was gonna tell you is, it goes like this, and these are just my own creations. Gas won't save your ass, but the brake might give you a break. And then I'll say Kit Kat, because that's your slogan. Give me a break. Other ones we've come up with, you've heard it already, no vision, no decision.
Yes.
I love to use analogies. I always say we want Tai Chi, not UFC. Mm-hmm. Smooth, steady, gradual, fluid moving. Stop so you can see the tires and pavement again. So we've used that term 2 times, Mandy. We stop so we can see tires and pavement when it's typically a car. The bigger the vehicle, the bigger the space I encourage. So if it's a truck, you stay further back to try to retain your peripheral vision. Okay. If it's a bus, a London Transit bus, I leave the length of the bus in front. Why? So that if I choose to make a lane change around the bus, I have room within my lane to accelerate and come around. So you need a smaller window of opportunity. It has nothing to do with aggression, right?
Yes.
It has to do with technique.
Yes.
If you stop typically behind a bus, you have to pull out, then you get to accelerate. So you'll need a bigger window of opportunity.
Makes sense, yeah.
And also, we encourage everybody nowadays, because of distracted driving, that when you brake, check your rear view. You want to see, are the people paying attention behind you, or are they doing what I call hashtag the crotch watch, you know, looking at their phones, God forbid. Yeah, let them move off, count 1, 2, 3, create separation, right?
Yes.
And as you approach, look left, right, left quickly. You're looking for 1 in a million person running through a red light or stop sign. In the winter, they could be skidding because of the snow conditions. The road markings here are hard to see here in London because the quality of the paint is honestly garbage. Look far ahead to the lights up ahead. It's the main intersection in London, Wellington and Commissioners, and probably the widest as well. So you've got 3 lanes going straight, a left turn lane and a right turn lane as well. We can see the countdown timer is at 20 seconds plus, so we know we're good to go, potentially. And as you approach, glance left and right, if you can, if you're comfortable doing so. That's it, my brother. Speed-wise, you're pretty solid, too. We encourage our students to stick within 5 over, 5 under of the limit in preparation for the road test, right? 10 over, to today's ministry standards, will probably get you failed on a road test.
Okay.
With rare exceptions. Now, we have the garbage truck, which is restricting our vision, which is not a big deal, but we want to keep our distance back, and potentially we do want to go around it at some point.
Yes.
Because we don't like the lack of vision, because you just don't know when they're going to brake, what's going to happen. Look left, right as you go, minor intersections, so you don't have to move your head as much. And you peekaboo the rear view once again. If you've already done it, forgive me. Speed's excellent. The right lane is turning into a turning lane for cars exiting. So watch these cars to have a right signal on, or they're going to come over to our lane because their lane is ending. Because the lane ends at these traffic lights.
Yes. Yeah, like this car.
There's an overhead sign indicating that. It's a walking symbol. We know the lights are fresh. That's it, my brother. Pace-wise, always keep it on covering your brake because we see them slowing down. That's it. If we do a good job of maintaining distance, when people brake, our first reaction typically is lift off the gas, right? Okay. If we're doing it right. Stage 2 is you cover the brake, and stage 3 is brake. But if we're following too closely, then you'll have to go to the brake right away. And we're looking up ahead, eye lead time, targeting our intended path, and you're doing a great job. Way to go. Speed's great, lane position's excellent. Here we can see a sign, black and yellow, which is a warning sign, warning us that we have a fire station, not to block entrance or accessibility for the emergency services. The road opens up again to more lanes, Mandeep. We'll continue to stick to this lane because eventually it will narrow back to 2 lanes again. The right lane again, because Wellington is a major commercial area, is basically an exit lane for all the businesses on Wellington Road. Once again, as you slow, you check that rear view, my brother, and give this to guy time, and we'll roll up. Never use the gas when you don't have to. We really promote, I love to promote avoiding unnecessary braking. It's what I encourage all my kids to do. Challenge yourself to be very efficient with braking, acceleration, etc. If you do this, you're more fluid and you get better fuel economy as well.
Okay.
So a smart driver pushes the gas, not according to what he wants, because we all want to push, pushes according to what he needs.
Yes.
Based on his observation. That's it. Let that car move off, create separation, look left, right, or as I like to do, do the Stevie Wonder, and keep on going. We have to remember, driving is not the Tour de France or F1 or IndyCar. We're not trying to catch the peloton, as they say in France. We want separation.
Yes.
Peekaboo that rear view if you haven't. If you have, forgive me. Speed's coming up beautifully. You're very good with your speed control. Bravo. We're approaching traffic lights again. The color of the light, you're going to notice no matter you want to or not. More importantly, it's a walking symbol. You know it's fresh to go.
Yes.
This truck is coming up a little bit aggressively on your left, Mandy. So what potentially runs through your head is that he might cut over. Right?
Yes.
Watch how much distance he gives to the car in front of him.
Okay.
If he continues to get tighter, he may be coming over. But I will also tell you, London statistically is rated as a very poor driving city. Statistically rated one of the worst in the country. And I will vouch for that wholeheartedly. Being from Toronto originally myself in Scarborough, I personally would rather drive there than here. Never mind, now traffic has picked up because London has had a lot of growth in the last couple of years.
Yes.
Lights are green, it's a walking symbol, look left, right, and we're gone. Straight ahead, rooftop of that car, look far. That's it. Bend it a little bit to the left. That's it, my brother.